Hi everyone, my name's Sany and welcome back to my maths adventure. In this video, I'll be talking about self-studying the hardest A-level in the UK. So I hope you can join me. So in my last video, I talked about whether I'll be self-studying the hardest A-level in the UK, which is further maths. After much deliberation, because you know, I need expert advice sometimes, I've decided to go for it. So you may be wondering why I'm self-studying A-level further maths. If you stick around, I'll give you my top five reasons. So if you haven't already, I really appreciate it if you can hit that like button and turn on your notifications. It will really help me support my channel and help me grow for the future. So thank you. So my first top reason is university requirements. Further maths is an important A-level subject to take if you're considering going to top UK university, not only just to study mathematics, but other subjects as well. Now, further maths is considered a facilitating subject, which means that some of the top UK universities require you to have it. Now, some of the universities require only A-level further maths to AS level. However, the vast majority of them require the full A-level. Some universities like Cambridge University, University College London, Warwick University, Imperial College London, Durham University, just to name a few. However, I will say that most UK universities don't require you to have A-level further maths. One notable exception is Oxford University. Now, Oxford University recommends that you have A-level further maths, however, it's not essential. For me personally, if I want to stand a good chance of getting into a top UK university, then A-level further mathematics is an essential qualification to have. Now, my second reason is the first year advantage at university. Now, some universities don't actually require you to have A-level further maths. However, they do recommend that you study it if it's available to you. Evidence from other YouTubers who did a maths degree have said that A-level further maths is like the first year of a maths degree at university. So if you studied further maths before starting a maths degree at university, you would have already had the opportunity to increase your overall mathematics knowledge, experience in dealing with complicated maths concepts, and also just increase your confidence in mathematics overall. So by studying further maths, you would have a distinct advantage compared to other students who didn't take it. Now, my third reason is that it will increase my overall math skills. Now, I will learn the bulk of my mathematics knowledge from my A-level mathematics. However, if I was to study further mathematics, I'll learn other subjects that aren't covered by the normal A-level math syllabus. These subjects are like complex numbers, matrices, hyperbolic functions, chi squared distribution, work, energy, power, and the physics of circular motion. So not only I'll be learning new subjects that I've just mentioned, but also I'll get an opportunity to broaden my skills and consolidate my mathematical knowledge in the standard A-level mathematics syllabus as well. Now, my fourth reason is being in a small minority of students who actually had the opportunity to study A-level further mathematics. Now, a report published by the Joint Council for Qualifications showed that in 2019, over 91,000 students in the UK sat the A-level mathematics exam. Now, that's compared to only over 14,000 students who sat the A-level further mathematics exam. Another interesting statistic from the 2019 report is that approximately over half the students who sat the A-level further mathematics exam obtained A star grade or an A grade. Now, A-level further mathematics does have a high barrier to entry, which means that you do need an A star or 8 to 9 in GCSE mathematics. However, even if you did have the grades, fewer students even have the motivation to study it in the first place. Theoretically, I know that I will have a high chance of obtaining a great A-level further maths grade at the end if I just work hard and apply myself. Now, if you want to check out the report by the Joint Council for Qualifications, I'll put a link in the description. I think another important reason why I want to actually do A-level further maths is the actual challenge itself. A-level further maths is one of the hardest, if not the hardest A-level in the UK. So I wanted the challenge of doing something difficult that also stretches my mathematical ability. You don't grow by doing easy things in life, you grow by doing things that are challenging, that pushes your limits, and sometimes doing things that make you fail. Now, I could be setting up myself for failure. However, if I do fail, I want to fail fast and fail forward so I can learn from those mistakes and use those for failures to propel myself forward for future success. Now, in my last video, I talked about watching the launch of the SpaceX spacecraft. Now, the next day, I got the opportunity to watch the SpaceX Dragon spacecraft docking with the International Space Station. And what a historic moment that was, just seeing the experience live on TV as the spacecraft approached the ISS and slowly maneuvered into position and started its docking procedures. Once docking was completed, the two astronauts came inside the ISS.
There we go, guys, they're coming through.
We have Bob Behnken from SpaceX Demo 2 mission entering the International Space Station.
History being made.
Followed by Doug Hurley.
One of the American astronauts, Doug Hurley, said something very inspirational, and I think it will stick for me for the rest of my life.
And folks at SpaceX, folks at NASA, the Commercial Crew Program put their heads together and worked diligently year after year, making sacrifices, working hard, and then 9 years later, American launch capability was restored, and this is just one effort that we can show for the ages in this dark time that we've had over the past several months to kind of inspire especially the young people in the United States to reach for these lofty goals and work hard and look what you can accomplish.
So if you enjoy the process of working hard, reaching for higher goals and applying yourself to a worthwhile endeavor, there's nothing that you can't achieve in your life, no matter how difficult. So that's it from me today. I really hope you enjoyed this video and got some value out of it. If you did, I would appreciate it if you can hit that like button. Now in my next video, I'll be talking about books and giving you a tour of my bookshelf. Now, as you can tell from behind me, I've managed to actually recover most of all my books that were in storage. So I've just got to sort all these out and get it into some sort of order. I may need a second bookshelf actually. But in my part of the world in Wales, IKEA is still closed. So hopefully you can join me for that bookshelf tour. So don't forget to hit that subscribe button and turn on your notifications to get a reminder when that video is up. So wherever you are in the world, stay safe, take care, and I'll see you next week.
So here's my Amazon package with my first two further mathematics textbooks. So I'm just going to do an unwrapping. There you have. So there you have it, book one and book two. Complex numbers, arcing diagrams. Roots of polynomials, matrices, book two, more complex numbers, polar coordinates, hyperbolic functions.